Hello everyone, Mischlings here with my B-side, first B-side Let's Play, Goof Troop for the Super Nintendo. It was a great day for fishing in Spoonerville, so Goofy and his pals headed out to the ocean with their boats. Cruising for the big ones in open water, Pete and PJ were suddenly caught in the ominous shadow of a gigantic ship. When Goofy and Max looked up, they saw a huge pirate ship heading out to Spoonerville Island. Pete and PJ were on board, victims of a pirate kidnapping. Goofy rowed for all he was worth, but he couldn't catch up to the pirate ship before it landed on the island. Determined to rescue their friends, Goofy and Max set out to explore the island and find the pirate stronghold. That was an all too dramatic reading of a thin plot for this game. Now I'm going to play as Max. He's the character I played as most as a kid, and I'm just used to the way he plays. He's a bit faster than Goofy. I don't know what other differences there are between the two of them, but yeah, that is one of them. Now, I hope I won't have to put too much exposition in the very beginning of this, because this game really is quite simple. I would call it kind of a very, very light version of the puzzle solving and dungeon kind of things you'll see crop up in Zelda games, but obviously, like I said, very kind of watered down and simplified as opposed to that. Now, as you see, he's putting his hands up. That happens when you press B. You use B to pick things up and set them down. And Y is to use whatever item you have, like right here. I got a grappling hook. And you press Y and you fire out the grappling hook, which has its uses, one of which I'm about to show you right now. Now, one thing that happens with pretty much everywhere is that the enemies respawn after you leave a screen. And they, well, come back later, as you may obviously be able to tell, which I actually was just repeating myself there. But anyway, what I wanted to show you was, now if you look with the grappling hook right here, you can pick up the barrel from a distance. Now, you can also do that again from over here, which allows you to, as you can tell, get the block over to the side, kick that block over to the side and collect these items. This kind of purplish diamond is an extra life, and the blue one is a continue for once you've run out of all your lives. Now, and what should be kind of maybe hopefully the last bit of exposition for the time being, up there next to the grappling hook thing that I'm gesturing towards, these hearts, those are your life. As you collect that, if you get hurt, you lose all of the hearts you have remaining, and if you have no hearts remaining, then you lose a life. Now, the grappling hook on enemies like the snake and some right there will kill them. Most like the pirates, just knocks them back. And, well, we kind of don't need another one here, but I'll grab another one anyway. Now, this is, you could call it a kill room, where you have to kill all of these pirates to move on. But I don't actually remember which way I just went here. Yeah, nothing we can do for right now. Mm-hmm. See that plank of wood in the upper left? Yeah, we need to go and get that, so once we do that, then we can do something on that screen. I always forget the order of things. Now, I did do a practice run of this game recently, I'll call it. It was actually a failed attempt to record it. I did record the game. I actually recorded the game in its entirety, and then the video file got corrupted. So, yeah, I was not happy that day. Now, these gates. You kick a block onto the switch, and, well, you open the gate. Now, the shovel here allows you to obviously dig things up, and I want to try and kill that bee thing, because there we go, otherwise he'll get in my way when I try to shovel. And so you can dig in areas that look like this, so let's see what we find here. All in all, not too bad. Alright then, so next we gotta move on to this area to the right, and come on, bee, I don't like you. I don't like any insects. They're just not They disagree with me. There we go. Yay. Plank. Now I'll meet you back in that room. Okay, back here. All we really need to do right there is set that plank down. And can I kill the frog? I can kill the frog. And underneath the egg is just a cherry and a bird comes flying out. I did not remember that fact. I probably should have. Now, as I was saying, against most of the pirate enemies, all the hookshot grappling hook does is push them backwards. It doesn't kill them, but in this case, you can push them into the water, and there that way you kill them. See, the game is just handing out the lives and continues early on in this, which, alright, fair enough. I picked up something that gave me a life. That's kind of useful, because I'm not great at this game. It's one of those, I'm playing it mostly because I grew up with it. But it's still a pretty good game. Not perfect by any means, but pretty good. Okay. Now, if anything this game is remembered for, and the people who have played it and remember it, it's for these block puzzles. Now, these start off simple enough, as you may be able to see. I pretty much saw the solution as soon as I walked in here. Now, when I was a kid, that was a different story. But they start off simple. There's one at the end. Oh, boy. The infamous one is the one at the very end of the game, which, you know, that's just kind of the way these things work. The hardest thing is always at the end because, well, you need a difficulty curve. You need a logical progression. You don't want things to go all over the place with bizarre difficulty in an early level and then low difficulty for no good reason in a later level. And, yay! I actually hit him from that distance. I'm surprised. I didn't think that was going to work. Now, a key. I didn't show you where we need to use the key, because I'm just heading back to that point, which happens to be in the one door we haven't gone through here, down there, up the top, see the thing with the lock and stuff? Yeah, key. Now these hedgehogs, they gotta be hedgehogs. It's the only thing I can think that these things could possibly be. Those, you can just kill them with a grappling hook. And why not be... And there we go. We pick up another life. Now, one thing that's unfortunate about this first level is that it really doesn't show off the grappling hook and the reason you have it, which is unfortunate. I mean, it is useful. Yeah, this spot right up here, we're going to come back here later, and it's not fun. It's, well, I don't know if that's the fairest assessment of it. But it's definitely a lot more tedious than it should be. Well, we'll get to that when we get there. Like I said, not a perfect game, has its flaws. Now, yay, another block kicking puzzle. I would hope you'd be able to see the solution to this, because this one, again, you start off easy. It's got a very good first level kind of difficulty in this game. But then you get to the later ones. And there we go. Get the big key, the boss key, whatever you want to call it. And then now all we gotta do is get to the boss. Well, then we gotta beat the boss. So I guess there is somewhat of a challenge in there, maybe. And yeah, using the grappling hook to knock back enemies is possibly one of the most useful things in this game. Now, oh boy, how do I want to do this? Let's see. Nope, that's not gonna work. Okay, so what I'm gonna try to do is, I didn't point this out earlier, but the bell will draw all the enemies towards you, and you can tell I didn't think this one through, because what exactly am I? Oh, got it. Okay, all right, come on, yay! There we go. See. That's the part that's kind of tedious, because I often stupidly done that without the bell, and that gets pretty difficult. So now we're on to the boss.
We will smash you. We will crush. We will bash you into mush.
I have always loved that, this opening line. When I was a kid, I always thought it was hilarious because of the way they said it. Now, this is pretty simple. You've got, oh my god, I can't remember what these enemies' names were. Because these all have names, but I just don't remember any of them. And you gotta... There's a bunch of them hiding in here. Once you've exhausted the barrels down there, you've gotta kill them using their own weapons, because they will throw barrels and bombs at you. Now those spiny, red spiny things you can't grab, because, you know, they're big and red and spiny. Of course you wouldn't be able to grab them. Not a good time to have my eye itch. Ah! Yep, see, that's... Wow, that's the first time I'm taking damage. Come on. Come on! Somebody! Papa, it's like I try to watch the middle, but they don't show up in the middle at the right timing. Okay? Ow! Ow, I missed! Wow, that was... There we... Freaking! This should be easier than I'm making it look. There we go. There we go. Come on, there. Come on. No, no. Is there just the one left? Okay. I'm waiting until you come out of the center one right here. Right here. Right here, guy. What is your name? What is your name? I've forgotten your name, but show up in the center. Okay. Yeah! There we go. Stage clear! 10 minutes, 8 seconds, and that was Mischlings here with part 1 of Goof Troop. I will see you guys next time.